The grandstands are full to capacity, and it's no surprise everyone is really excited to see what's going to happen in the German Grand Prix this weekend at the Hockenheimring. We're racing in the Rhine Valley this weekend, at the home of many of the sport's finest competitors. The 2.8-mile Hockenheimring requires precision through the technical stadium section and great raw speed down the long, flat-out curve towards the popular overtaking zone of the Turn 6 hairpin. Watch out for a lot of wheel-to-wheel action there today. We're almost ready to go then, and this is what the starting grid looks like for today's race. An immense lap from Lewis Hamilton yesterday puts him on pole position, with Nico Rosberg alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Ricciardo, Vettel, Max Verstappen, and Raikkonen, Massa, Bottas, Grosjean, and Carlos Sainz. another fantastic victory for the Silver Arrows. And I have to wonder, Anthony Davidson, just what set them apart from the competition here?
Well, they clearly have a car that comes alive in the kind of conditions we were dealing with today. It's a very balanced package in the wet, and what that means is that the drivers have confidence to attack. And having that confidence gets you on the power earlier, it lets you brake later, and can put you a long way up the road.
Hi. I'm Emma Jenkins. I'm a specialist in contract law, and I've been brought in to work as your agent. I'll be working to get you the best deal in the boardroom, which means you need to do the best possible job out there on the circuit. When you get new contract offers, either from new teams or an amendment to your existing offer, it'll come through me. I'll also keep you up to date on discussions behind the scenes to change your terms, or any specific goals that the team has set for you. If a contract offer does come through, I'll present to you the available offers and then you can make the call. I assume that all sounds fine. Well then, good luck this season and I'll catch you later.
We're about to join the action in what is sure to be an interesting practice session here in Melbourne. It's not long until we get the session underway and we'll have some cars appearing out on the track. I'm here with Anthony Davidson once again. Nice to see you, Ant. And I wanted to ask you about how you go about improving the car over the course of a practice session. How much would you say is already known from the pre-race simulations? And how much do you have to do, you know, how much do you have to work on with a real car on a real circuit?
Well, that's a good question, Crofty. And I suppose the simple answer is that there's no such thing as too much information. As you say, the bigger teams have very complex simulations. Vast numbers of clever people crunching the numbers back at base, but what they can't tell you is stuff like how the track condition's going to be, or what the temperature's going to be doing over the course of the day, and how all of that's going to be interacting with the tyre. There are so many millions of tiny variables involved in getting these cars around a racetrack quickly, but the computer can't tailor the car to a driver's specific balance requirements. At some point, you still need to put a human being in there and have them feel it through the seat of their pants. And that's why we end up with different drivers having different setups. So what I'm trying to say is, Crofty, nothing beats on-track testing.
cars are set on the grid for what promises to be a thrilling contest here in Baku. Hold on tight then, it's race day for the European Grand Prix. With 20 turns and a length of 3.7 miles, Baku City Circuit in the heart of the Azerbaijan capital is a real test of a driver's endurance, patience and precision. 90 degree corners through Sector 1 lead into a tightening uphill sprint as we start to circle around the old city. Then a 1.4 mile chase flat out through Sector 3 towards the finish line. I won't be commentating alone today, of course. Nope, I have the honour to share this commentary box with none other than Anthony Davidson. And you and I were talking earlier today about how tight that midfield battle is compared to the last couple of years. Why do you think that is?
Well, I suppose the main reason is simply stability in the regulations. Look at what we had towards the end of the V8 era. In 2012, we had 7 winners in 7 races. And we talk about the dominance of Red Bull at that time, but their advantage was rarely more than 2 or 3 tenths of a second. And we've had this current formula now for a couple of years, and that serves to solve any teething troubles with reliability. And let's not forget that these cars are more technical than ever before, so it was always going to take a bit of time for those gaps to come down.
Keep your eyes open on the run to turn one and keep it clean. We want to come out in one piece. Good luck.
Thank you.
great win then for the Mercedes team today. Tell me, Ant, what was the key to this success?
Well, I think the track conditions just really suited their car today. Wind, track temperature, you name it. These cars come alive when the tyres are just at the right temperature. So the more easily you can keep them there, the better your race tends to go. And that's exactly what happened. Their car just looks so comfortable out there.
So as I say that, we can see the drivers coming out now to collect their trophies. It's yet more silverware to take back to their base in Brackley after another excellent Grand Prix. So then, it's time to see how this result affects the Drivers' Championship.